Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome to the series PIB 24/7. In this session we will discuss 5 questions from the PIB news. Okay, so let's begin with the session. So in today's session the pattern of questions is again different. You have been given a paragraph and after reading the paragraph you have to answer the given questions. Okay, so according to the Electronic Industries Association of India, ELSINA, the value of electronic components market in India has increased from ₹68,342 crore in 2015-16 to ₹131,832 crore in 2018-19, with an aim to boost domestic manufacturing along with attracting investment in electronic component manufacturing. The cabinet has approved 3 schemes in March 2020. Number 1 is Electronics Manufacturing Cluster Scheme. Number 2, Production Linked Incentive Scheme for Large Scale Electronics Manufacturing. And number 3 is Scheme for Promotion of Manufacturing of Electronic Components and Semiconductors. And jo hamare questions given honge wo in 3 schemes ke base pe honge. Okay, so question number 1 is, the 3 mentioned schemes in the passage are in line with which national policy of India? Okay, so ye jo tino schemes hain ye kaun si national policy of India ke according hai? So guys, let me tell you the answer first. The answer to this question is National Policy for Electronics 2019. Okay, and now let us discuss about the National Policy for Electronics. So it is a step taken by Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology headed by Ravi Shankar Prasad, whose Lok Sabha constituency is Patna Sahib. Okay, he is Lok Sabha MP from Patna Sahib. This National Policy aims to improve the global position of the Indian electronic system design and manufacturing industries, and it will lead to the formulation of several schemes, initiatives, projects and measures for the development of ESDM sector in the country. So there is also a target which is to promote domestic manufacturing and export in the entire value chain of ESDM for economic development to achieve a turnover of US$400 billion, which is approximately 26 lakh crore by 2025. Okay, and this national policy will also create an ecosystem for competitive ESDM sector, and also it provides incentives and support for manufacturing of core electronic components. Okay, core electronic components ke liye ye incentive provide karata hai, support provide karata hai, taki zyada se zyada electronic components ka manufacturing India mein kiya ja sake. Alright, and there is also a provision of creation of Sovereign Patent Fund. And what is this Sovereign Patent Fund, SPF? Guys, this is basically a state-led investment fund which seeks to acquire intellectual property resources in the country which are strategically valuable for national economic interest. Okay, let me repeat this. What is Sovereign Patent Fund? Sovereign Patent Fund, it is basically state-led investment fund jo ki state jari karegi, jo hamari government of India hai, wo jari karegi, that seek to acquire, jisme ki acquire kiye jayenge intellectual property resources jo ki hamare national economic interest ke liye valuable hai. Alright, so let me explain through an example. Let us say ki koi ek MSME sector mein का ओनर है. ओके, एमएसएमई सेक्टर का ओनर है. सो उसके पास इतना फंड नहीं है, वो इतनी ज्यादा महंगी हार्डवेयर और सॉफ्टवेयर को अफोर्ड नहीं कर सकता. सो व्हाट गवर्नमेंट विल डू, गवर्नमेंट विल अक्वायर द रिक्वायर्ड इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी फ्रॉम द ओनर एंड देन प्रोवाइड टू दिस एमएसएमई ओनर एट अ डिस्काउंटेड प्राइस. ओके, लेट मी रिपीट दिस. अगर कोई एमएसएमई ओनर है जिसके पास इतनी अफोर्डेबिलिटी नहीं है कि वो कोई महंगा हार्डवेयर या सॉफ्टवेयर खरीद सके, देन गवर्नमेंट जो है उस इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी रिसोर्स को अक्वायर करके एमएसएमई को प्रोवाइड कर सकेगी, और इस तरीके से जो हमारे इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स का मार्केट है वो बूस्ट कर जाएगा इंडिया में. ऑलराइट, सो आई होप गाइस दिस नेशनल पॉलिसी ऑन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स मैन्युफैक्चरिंग क्लस्टर्स स्कीम वुड सपोर्ट सेटिंग अप ऑफ Electronics Manufacturing Clusters EMC along with the setting up of. Now let us discuss first about this Electronics Manufacturing Clusters. So Union Cabinet has approved Electronics Manufacturing Cluster with an budget outlay of 3,762.25 crore. This is a scheme for development of world class infrastructure along with common facilities and amenities through electronics manufacturing cluster, and the main focus is on the setting up of two things, which are electronic manufacturing clusters and common facility centers. And what are these electronic manufacturing clusters and common facility centers? So electronic manufacturing clusters would be set up in geographical areas of minimum area, preferably adjacent. Okay, matlab jahan pe zyada se zyada manufacturing cluster lagaye ja sake. And the focus is on development of basic infrastructure, amenities and other common facilities for the ESDM units. Now what are these common facility centers? They would be set up in an area where a significant number of existing manufacturing units are already located, and the focus is on upgrading the common technical infrastructure. Jo infrastructure already exist karta hai usko upgrade karna, and providing common facilities for the units in the EMCs, industrial areas, parks or industrial corridors. Alright, so I hope guys this electronics manufacturing cluster is clear now. And what was the question? Question was, electronic manufacturing cluster scheme would support setting up of electronics manufacturing cluster along with the setting up of, so it will set up common facility centers. Okay, now next question is, what is the stretch of the incentive offered under the production linked incentive scheme for large scale electronic manufacturing on the incremental sales of electronic goods manufactured in India? So let us first discuss this scheme. So this scheme was approved with a budget outlay of approximately 40,995 crores, and it aims to boost domestic manufacturing along with attracting investments in electronic components manufacturing. And under this scheme, an incentive of 4-6% on incremental sale of goods manufactured in India is provided, and this scheme will likely to provide benefit to 5-6 major global players and few domestic champions in the field of mobile manufacturing and specified electronic component. So it will boost the mobile manufacturing in India, and it will also lead to employment generation, and it has a total employment generation potential of over 8 lakh 2 lakh directly and 6 lakh indirectly jobs over 5 years. Okay, so the incentive of 4-6% on incremental sales of goods manufactured in India is provided. So the answer to the question is 4-6%. All right, 4-6%. Now next question is, under the scheme for promotion of manufacturing of electronic components and semiconductors, financial incentive of -% will be offered on which type of expenditure for the manufacturing of goods? Now let us discuss this SPECS scheme first. So this scheme, the scheme for promotion of manufacturing of electronic components and semiconductors, has been approved by Union Cabinet with a budget outlay of 3,285 crores. It aims to help offset the disability of domestic manufacturing of electronic components and semiconductors. Electronic components and semiconductors ki jo domestic manufacturing hai uske andar jo bhi offset tha usko khatam karne ke liye scheme aaya hai. And the scheme is launched with a budget outlay of approximately 3,200 crores, and the expected benefits are the new investments of at least 20,000 crore, employment potential of approximately 6 lakh, reducing dependence on import of components, and development of electronic components manufacturing ecosystem. And under this scheme, the financial incentive of 25% will be offered on capital expenditure for the manufacturing of goods that constitute the supply chain of an electronic product. किसी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक प्रोडक्ट का अगर कोई सप्लाई चेन का कोई गुड मैन्युफैक्चर हो रहा है तो उसके लिए कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर पे 25% का फाइनेंशियल इंसेंटिव प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. सो इससे क्या होगा, इससे जो प्रोडक्शन है उसके अंदर बूस्ट मिलेगा और जितने भी मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट्स हैं वो ज्यादा से ज्यादा प्रोडक्शन करेंगे. ओके, सो द करेक्ट आंसर टू द क्वेश्चन इज 25% एंड ओनली ऑन कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर. ओके, See, 25%. So financial incentive of 25% will be offered on capital expenditure for the manufacturing of goods. Now last question for today is, read the following statements with respect to electronic production and choose which one is not correct. So let us first read all the options. It has been increased at a compound annual growth rate of about 30% during 2014-15 to 2018-19. It has been increased from 1,90,366 crore in 2014-15 to rupees 4,58,006 in 2018-19. India's share in global electronics manufacturing grew from 1.3% to 3% in 2018, and it accounts for 2.7% of India's GDP at present. Now let us have a look at some facts about the Indian electronic industry. So India's electronic production has increased at a common annual growth rate of about 25% during this year, and India's electronic production has increased from ₹190,366 crores in 2014-15 to ₹458,006 crores in 2018-19, and India's share in global electronic manufacturing grew from 1.3% to 3% in 2018, and it accounts for 2.3% of the India's GDP at present. So now let's come to the question. So what were the options? So this option is incorrect, because this is about 25%. This is absolutely correct. This is absolutely correct. And this is also incorrect, because this percentage is 2.3%. So therefore we have to identify the incorrect statement, and hence A, 1 and 4 is the correct answer. Okay guys, so that's it for today's session. These were the 5 questions. I hope you like this session. For more updates, do subscribe our channel anujindal.in and press the bell icon. Milte hain next session mein. Goodbye, take care, God bless, and keep watching PIB 24/7.